In today's class, I will be discussing best wire size. Best wire size, what does it mean and why it is to be used?
Best wire size is the wire of such a diameter that contact points of the wire must be on the pitch line or effective diameter. As you can see in the given figure, B is the contact point. It is lying on the pitch line. This is the screw thread profile. If you want to measure the major diameter of the screw, for that we have to use floating carriage micrometer. I have discussed floating carriage micrometer in my previous class. In floating carriage micrometer, there are anvil which are in cylindrical shape. These are the pointed edges of screw thread which is in contact with the anvil. So there will be a point contact. If there is a point contact, chances of slipping of anvil will more. In that case, the reading which we are going to make, there will be error. In order to avoid that, what we will do? We are inserting wires having circular cross section or circular geometry. These three wires will be placed in a groove of screw thread. Because of the presence of this wire, we are going to get even surfaces and the chances of error would be reduced. Here we are not going to use any random wire. If we are using two wire, then it is two wire method. If we are using three wires, then it is three wire method. Three wire method will give you more accurate reading than two wire. If D is the diameter of the wire and P is your pitch of the screw thread, P is the pitch of the thread and distance from here to here, it will be P by 2 half of the pitch, and AB will be P by 4. If this angle is denoted as theta, theta means half of the thread angle. If this is theta and if this is 90 degree, then this will be 90 minus theta. If OB is the perpendicular line on the flank, then angle OBA it will be equal to 90 minus theta, that is equal to theta. And what will be angle BOA? It will be 90 minus theta, means this angle will be theta and this angle will be 90 minus theta. If in the given figure, if it is theta and this is 90 minus theta, then sin 90 minus theta will be equal to AB divided by OB. And we know that sin 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. Then cos theta will be equal to AB divided by D by 2. Because OB is half of the diameter of the wire. Then D by 2 will be equal to AB divided by cos theta. And D will be equal to twice of AB divided by cos theta. And D will be equal to twice of AB sec theta. As we know that 1 by cos theta is equal to sec theta. Then D will be equal to 2 into P by 4 into sec theta. As we earlier know that AB is equal to P by 4. So we get the final result. D is equal to P by 2 sec theta. For best wire size, D is equal to P by 2 sec theta.
Final expression for best wire size is dB is equal to P by 2 sec theta, where P is equal to pitch of the screw thread and theta is equal to half of the thread angle. This is for today's class. In my next class, I will be discussing how to measure effective diameter by three wire method.